It actually says on here, is a little word, I don't know if you can see it, it says tourer. So in other words, this is intended to be a motorcycle or scooter that you would use for more than just your routine commute.
Right.
You could ride on it every day, get 50 to 60 miles per gallon, maybe even a little more, depending on how judicious you are with the throttle. But the idea of this cycle is that you can take it anywhere and go over any mountain and pass that you're likely to find. You want to ride this one all the way to New York and back? Go ahead.
You could do it. So you could ride this on a long distance, not just a commute, you could actually use this as a serious motorcycle.
This would be a replacement for a motorcycle for some folks that are tired of shifting. I had a customer not too long ago had a bad wrist, and he thought that pulling that left brake lever would be something he wouldn't do nearly as often as pulling that left clutch lever on his bike. And it actually helped him out. He was able to ride for a longer period of time, an older gentleman.
Right.
This bike also has storage under the seat. I meant to mention that earlier. Instead of having to use a key, however, it's got an electric release. So you push this little button here, and the seat opens right up. Now, there's not enough room in here for a helmet. This particular one has a couple of tabs that you can hang a helmet on, and in some cases, there's a locking bar. The earlier models all had a locking bar. Currently, they've only got it on some of the BV500s.
Right. But you can put a box on the back here that could store a helmet?
Piaggio produces a box that is about, bigger than a helmet. You can put your helmet in there, gloves, maybe a sandwich too. And the saddlebags are big enough for the kind of things that you might routinely take to work, a small laptop, a rain suit. As we spoke about earlier, it's always important to be ready for the weather.
Sure.
And, miscellaneous items. And if you were to go touring, you'd have to pack light, but you could take a fair amount of stuff.
Now, this, as I said, is more of a serious motorcycle. It's got some very trick-looking front brakes. It's got two front forks as opposed to the single-sided ones of the LX150. And it looks like it has two sets of brakes up front.
The main reason that this scooter is more like a motorcycle is it's got a lot more power than your typical scooter. It also has two brakes on the front. Now, this is important because, like all vehicles, your best braking is done with the front wheel. We don't notice this in our car when we step on one pedal and brake four wheels, but it's very important on a motorcycle. The primary reason it has two brakes on the front is because A, it has more weight, B, it has more power. So if you're, you know, zooming down the freeway at 70 miles an hour, you want to be able to stop safely. So, again, large wheels for safety and handling, extra braking, and you asked something else.
Well, I was going to actually ask you about the starting mechanism, because I think most people have the idea that scooters and motorcycles have to be done with the right leg, and things have progressed on fairly nicely. We have actually got push-button starts on these things.
While this is like a motorcycle, it has lost some of the characteristics that sometimes people associate with old bikes, like kickstarting. You don't have to jump up on the seat and push down on the kickstarter. It's got a simple push-button start, just like all modern motorcycles do.
Fantastic.
It has electronic ignition and fuel injection. Not all the scooters do, but the top-line scooters do.
Right. I also noticed standing here that you have a fuel gauge. That's obviously very useful. This has got slightly more instrumentation than some of the smaller models.
Right.
What sort of gas mileage would you expect from this 500cc version?
Piaggio says that this scooter can get 60 miles per gallon. It's been my understanding from the customers I've sold it to that they get 60 to 65 miles per gallon. Kind of depends on, again, how you ride it. I would expect that you could find a range from 55 to 65 miles per gallon.
And that's pretty similar to the LX150 that we were talking about earlier.
Actually,
maybe just 5 to 10 miles and more per
gallon. Well, the LX150 is closer to 70 routinely, regardless of use.
So we're moving on to the MP3, which is sort of undefinable. It's not really a motorcycle. Is it a scooter? It's got three wheels instead of two. So what is it?
The MP3 is the most unusual vehicle on the road.
It certainly is.
It's a scooter by definition. It has a leg shield. It has an automatic transmission. It's very simple to operate. However, it's got, unlike most scooters, it's extremely stable almost from the moment you pull the throttle. That thing is rock solid on the road. It handles beautifully through the corners. You can actually ride it aggressively like a motorcycle. You can lean it very far over, go very fast, or you can just ride it and use that stability to your advantage in traffic.
And the stability comes from the fact that you have two wheels at the front instead of one, obviously.
Precisely.
So you've got more rubber contact with the road. So a lot of people have mentioned to me when they're thinking of becoming a motorcyclist, well, they don't like those metal manhole covers that you have in the roads, and they get a little bit slippery in the wet. Obviously, with two wheels on the ground, that's kind of a thing of the past. You can be very, very liberal with your cornering, if you like.
Exactly. One of the advantages to the great handling characteristics of the MP3. It doesn't seem to matter what the terrain is. If there's a pothole, a manhole cover, some slippery surfaces, a little sand on the road, you just ride right through it as if it wasn't there. It's really nice. The front end is independently suspended, so the one wheel can meet a bump and the other wheel just tracks straight through.
Fantastic. Now we're going to see this being ridden by you later on in the program. The unusual thing that most people probably don't understand so far, just by looking at it, is that it actually leans like a motorcycle.
It does.
You wouldn't have thought that would be the case with three wheels. How does that all work? It looks like it might be a very, very complex set of linkages in the front here.
It's got a fairly complex set of linkages in the front, as you point out. It really does. Actually, in our shop, we have one completely uncowled if you want to look at it.
Great, that's good.
The linkage on the front end of the Piaggio three-wheelers is unique to their design. They came up with it, they came up with the idea for it, and they came up with the design. One of the nice things about it is absolutely smooth. After the first time you ride it, you will never even think that you have three wheels except to enjoy the stability.
Right. Okay, so we've moved over to this silver model, which is a 250cc version.
Exactly, but half the engine displacement, just as good handling, just as much power for the useful everyday stuff. Now, the 500 is a very aggressive looking, cool looking scooter. This is a really practical scooter.
Yeah.
It's got huge storage under the seat, and its handling is just as good, and it'll go 75 miles an hour on the freeway, so it'll cover all your commuting bases, and it'll get up to 70 miles per gallon if you behave yourself.
That's fantastic. Now, with the three-wheeled configuration, when you come to a stoplight, does it just fall over? Do you have to put your feet down? What happens?
Once you start moving on the scooter, if you have the front end locked, that is to say stabilized, as soon as you start to move, it will unlock and you'll be able to ride freely through traffic. When you come to a stop, however, it does not automatically lock. You have to deliberately lock it. There's a switch here on the handlebar. You push that switch in one direction and it will stabilize the front end for you. Then you can put your feet back up and wait for the light to change. It's pretty nice.
So you just literally twist and go from the light.
Turn the throttle, go, it automatically unlocks and you're back on a motorcycle.
Fantastic. Are there any other features that are radically different from a normal scooter? So if you've been riding a scooter before, you can easily transition to this?
If you've been riding other motorcycles or scooters, this is really easy to learn to ride. Your initial impression when you first sit on it and you unlock the front end, you go, whoa, that front end is a lot heavier than I expected. That feeling goes away the instant you pull the throttle. Although it is physically heavy, you've got two wheels up there, you've got brakes and suspension system, it actually handles so lightly you won't even remember that you're on a three-wheeler. Until you come to a stop, lock the front end, and relax while you keep your feet up and not have to hold it.
Fantastic.
The other advantage to that locking mechanism is when you park, you don't have to put it on the stand. Typically on a scooter like the LX150 over there, you have to put it on the stand every time. It's not hard, it's not a burden, but it sure is convenient not to have to do it.
Right. And as we were discussing before, some women may find it difficult to learn how to put it on the stand. Some, you know, if you're not particularly strong, it can be a little bit troublesome. So this eliminates all of that.
It's got a parking brake.
Wow.
So when you stop it and lock it, that is to say lock the front end up, take the key out. Once the key is out, you can't accidentally unlock it. You set the parking brake and you walk away.
So by law, as this is a three-wheeler, are there any other differences? Do you have to wear a helmet?
Because this is a three-wheeled motorcycle by California definition, you do not have to have a motorcycle license.
Ah.
It's covered under the same rules as a trike, like an old Harley three-wheeler or a Can-Am Spyder or the other three-wheeled scooters on the market. However, because it's still a motorcycle, you do have to wear a helmet and you have to obey all the rules and regulations that cover motorcycles.
Well, I think really the best thing to do with this particular trike, if I can call it that, is to see you ride it.
Sure.
Let's go do that.
Okay.
Fantastic.
Designed by Piaggio, the parallelogram suspension system provides exceptional dynamic stability. The front end, consisting of two independent tilting wheels, allows the rider to lean at an angle of up to 40 degrees. The MP3 is also distinguished by exceptional braking performance. Three powerful 240mm disc brakes up front with twin piston calipers allow record deceleration and a stopping distance more than 20% shorter than two-wheeled scooters, even with ABS.